بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. My dear students of Islamic Society of Vaughan, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the door of Al-Jannah for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the happiness and al-barakat. Dear students, inshallah, we're going to have a new lecture today. And the subject of the lecture would be regarding Azkaar after prayer. So inshallah, me and Ibrahim and Al-Yamama, we will discuss about that and I will ask them and they will answer inshallah me. So what I want you to do, I want you to watch this video 2, 3, 4 times and also to memorize Al-Adhkar because it's very important and you need to memorize Al-Adhkar after prayer because you will say it after every single prayer. So after Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, and Maghrib and Isha, you will have to say this adhkar and you have to follow a sunnah what the Prophet said because there are many brothers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them have no idea about that. They just say some adhkar, but inshallah today we will learn the proper adhkar, what the Prophet used to say and what does the sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So inshallah we will start now. Ibrahim and Yamama, are you ready?
Yes.
MashaAllah. So after finishing the prayer, when you say Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. So what do you have to say immediately after that? Could you say it together, please?
Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Okay. Allahumma anta as-salam wa minka as-salam. Tabarakta ya da jalali wal ikram. La ilaha illa Allah, wahdahu la sharika lah. Lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamd. وهو على كل شيء قدير لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه له النعمة وله الفضل وله الثناء والحسن لا إله إلا الله مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت
ما شاء الله. Perfect. So this is the first part. Then after saying these adhkar, what is the next? What to say?
Astaghfirullah 33 times.
Alhamdulillah 33 times.
Allahu
Akbar 33 times. Then Allahu Akbar 33 times. But you need to finish 100. So you have now 33 is 99. So you need to say one dhikr to reach 100. So what is the dhikr, Yamana?
La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamd wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir.
MashaAllah. So when you say 33, subhanallah, 33, alhamdulillah, 33, Allahu Akbar. Then you say at the end, لا إله إلا الله وحده ولا شريك له ولا الملك ولا الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. Very good. What is the next? When you finish this, what you should say? So before that, how to use your fingers when you say Al-Adhkar, Ibrahim?
There's two parts. There's one where you use the spots in each and every finger, and there's one that you could just do this.
Okay, that's good. So there's two options. The first one like this, Subhanallah, 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 Subhanallah. Or to hold your fingers like this, we call aqd. Subhanallah, 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 Subhanallah. And only you have to use what?
Your right hand.
That's right, mashallah. So after finishing Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, then la ilaha illallah. So what do you say after that?
After Fajr and after Maghrib, you can't move from your spot. Till you say la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah lahu al-mulku wa al-hamdu yuhyi wa yumeetu wa ala kulli shay'in qadir 10 times.
So okay, so if you are after Fajr or after Maghrib, you need to say la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahu al-mulku wa lahu al-hamdu yuhyi wa yumeet wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir 10 times. So when you say that, Yamama, what is the reward from Allah? What is your ajr?
Allah will.
Will write what?
Will write 10 good deeds.
10 good deeds
for
you.
Take away 10 bad deeds.
And will remove 10 bad deeds.
Put 10 levels up. Put 10 levels of.
So he will put you. Or he will raise you in 10 levels, okay, in al-Jannah, subhanAllah, and the fourth one?
He will put you in al-Jannah or protect you from the shaitan.
And will protect you from al-shaytan. So four things you will say it. When you say, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamd, yuhyi wa yumit wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, 10 times after Fajr and Maghrib, you will get four things. Allah will write 10 hasanat for you, and will remove 10 bad deeds for you, and will raise you 10 levels in al-Jannah, and will protect you from al-Shaytan. What else? If you finish these al-Adhkar, so what do you have to recite after that?
Ayat
al-Kursi, which is the greatest ayah in the Quran. Could you recite Ayat al-Kursi together, please?
Allahu la ilaha illa hu. الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم.
ما شاء الله. Perfect. How many times you should recite Ayat al-Kursi?
One time.
Only one time after mandatory prayers. What else you should recite? What
surah? Surah al-Ikhlas, Surah al-Falaq, and Surah al-Nas. After Fajr and Maghrib, you have to recite them 3 times each.
Okay, so after al-Fajr and after al-Maghrib 3 times. What about Yamam after Dhuhr and Asr and Isha? How many times?
Just one time.
One time. So Surah al-Ikhlas, which is Qul huwa Allahu Ahad, Qul a'udhu bi Rabbil Falaq, Qul a'udhu bi Rabbil Nas. You read it after al-Fajr and al-Maghrib 3 times. And after Dhuhr and Asr and Isha, only one time. So when you finish that means you finish the adhkar, right? But there is dua. It's better to say it after Fajr, once. So what is the dua?
Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'a wa rizqan tayyiba wa amalan mutaqabbala.
Very good. So after Fajr, it's better to recite this dhikr to Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'a wa rizqan tayyiba wa amalan mutaqabbala. And also, it's better to say Allahumma ajirna minan nar 7 times. Allahumma ajirna
minan nar.
So when you say this, that means you finished Al-Adhkar, right?
Yeah.
So, my dear students, you have to memorize Al-Adhkar as Ibrahim and Al-Yamama now. They memorize it, mashallah. So I want you to memorize Al-Adhkar. It's not difficult. It just takes from you maybe one time or two times. You will memorize that, inshallah. Write this on a paper and put it in your wall. After prayer, watch this wall and read from the paper. And inshallah, you will memorize that very, very fast. Inshallah, after Ramadan, inshallah, I will test you. So, what do you need to do now after watching this video? You need to register your name on Facebook. So, watch this video and write your name and say, my name is, and I watch it, the video, inshallah. So, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the door of Al-Jannah for you. Ramadan Mubarak for all of you. And I am really happy to be, inshallah, with you. And I am really happy to give these lectures. And inshallah, in the future, we're going to have multi, inshallah, lectures. And I'm going to visit some students and going to record videos at their houses. It's not just with Ibrahim and Ibrahim. I will, inshallah, invite 2-3 students in every video, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.